Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video we will talk about clutch. We will see what does it do and how you are going to handle it. So let's start with this one. So see, the clutch is on the left side, okay, and it is handled by the left foot. Left foot has only one responsibility, that is to handle the clutch, okay. Right has two responsibility, to manage the accelerator and the brake, okay, to switch between these two. But the left one has only one responsibility, that is to handle the clutch, okay. So this clutch, what does it do? It disconnects the engine and the car, okay. I'll show you a small demo. See, I'm turning on the car, okay, and right now my car is in neutral gear, there is no gear engaged, okay, and I'm revving the engine. So I'm giving the race, but still the car doesn't move. Why? Because there is no gear engaged. The engine and the car are disconnected. Engine is running at a very high speed, but the power is not translated into the car. Okay. Now, if I engage a gear, then my car will move. Why? Because the engine and the car will get connected. Power of engine will translate into the car and our car will move. Okay. So, but even after engaging the gear, if you want to disconnect engine in the car, then you have to use a clutch. Let me show you the demo. See, I'm pressing the clutch, okay, the clutch is fully pressed and I'm engaging the gear. Now I'm again revving the engine. My car doesn't move and there is no problem, okay. So why? Because the engine is disconnected. Engine is running at a very high speed, but it's disconnected from the car, okay. So we discussed what this clutch does. Now let's see the use cases. See, there are two use cases. One is when you want to change the gear. So let's say your car is in first gear, okay, so the engine and car are already connected, they're running, okay, both are running in sync, and you want to move it to second gear. Before that, you have to disconnect engine in the car. How you would do? You would do with the clutch only, okay. So this is a use case to change the gear, okay. If you don't press the clutch and by mistake if you try to change the gear, what you would do? You would damage the gearbox and your car will also stop. So it's a thumb rule, when you want to change the gear, you have to press the clutch, okay, full clutch, not the half clutch, okay. Now that is the first use case. Second thing is, whenever you want to brake, whenever you want to, you know, stop your car, you have to press the clutch, okay. That is another thumb rule. So two thumb rule you have to remember. There is one more use case, the half clutch, that we will discuss in the practical sessions, okay. That's quite far from now, but right now you have to remember two things while changing the gear and while braking. So let me show you. See, whenever your right foot goes onto the brake, your left foot should go on the clutch. Thumb rule, okay, remember this. Whenever you want to stop or, you know, slow down your car, you should press the clutch, okay. So why this second rule is important? Whenever you put the brake, you have to press the clutch also. Why this is important? See, when your car is already rolling on the road, okay, that means the engine and the car are connected, okay, and they are running in sync, okay. Now whenever you put the brake, that means you want to stop the car, but at the same time you don't want engine to stop, okay. We never want engine to stop unless we, you know, turn off the key. So whenever you want to put the brake, you have to disconnect engine and the car, so that your car will stop, but at least the engine should keep running at a minimum RPM, okay. So that's the second use case. That's about the clutch. That's it guys. If you like this content, please hit the like button and do subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you.